acts you're about to see are real. There are no myths, no tricks, no cheats. Do not try these acts on your own. Each of the performers you see tonight is a trained professional, and I use that word loosely, risking their very life for your entertainment. The Performers Production Company event and its sponsors insist you do not, I repeat, do not try any act you see here tonight ever, and will not be responsible for any accident, maiming, dismemberment, or death you bring upon yourself or others for trying what we just told you not to do.
Here from Hollywood, California. Let me introduce you to some of the special guests that we have here upon my return. Ladies and gentlemen, our first performer, you've seen her on NBC on America's Got Talent. You've seen her on Super Kids in Germany and Little Big Shots Australia. How about a great big round of applause for La Pequeña Avenita Charlotte, the Little Spider. Next to her, of course, is a very famous young man. You've seen him on Steve Harvey's Little Big Shots, America's Got Talent, and even more, ladies and gentlemen. He's very famous for a lot of things, but you know him as Karenin the Green Monster. Yeah. And of course, our friend from the Great White North still joining us again this week because she hasn't learned any better. How about a big round of applause for Vivian Oblivion? Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're from Freak Show Deluxe. The Freak Show Deluxe show just has three simple rules. Rule number one, you must have fun. We can't have fun up here unless you are having fun out there. Rule number two, we need to know how much fun you're having. Whenever you see something you like, we want you to scream and yell. You see something you don't like, scream and yell anyway. We might get better. Rule number three, should you become confused, overwhelmed, or discombobulated by the amazing and astounding things you see upon our stage, you forget where you are and what you should be doing. All you need to do, follow rule number three, do what the sign says. Three signs, three simple directions. I'm gonna warm everybody up right now. Are you all ready? Yeah! All right, do what the sign says. Here it comes, sign number one. Not bad at all, but second sign, twice as loud. So loud in here that everybody in Fort Frontier wants to come in and run in to see what's going on. Sign number two. Ooh, that like the wind blowing through here, okay. Third sign, three times as loud. So loud in here that everybody in the park wants to come running to see what's going on. Here it comes, sign number three. Give yourselves a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. You absolutely deserve it. Now I want to do something special for you guys tonight. It's not something we usually do, but a lot of people have said, Reverend Tommy Gunn, because that's me, I'm your host of the show. They have said, Reverend Tommy Gunn, how did you learn the amazing and astounding stunts for Freak Show Deluxe? Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to show you right now. We have an amazing thing that we found in an old antique record store. It's an old record called How to Do Sideshow for Fun and Profit. That's how we learned. Would you guys like to see how we learned how to do things? Yeah! I was hoping you'd say that because there's no one better right now to show you than, ladies and gentlemen, get ready for Karenin the Green Monster. Hit the record, Abby.
Act number one, the human blockhead. To do this famous act correctly, you will need to choose a volunteer from your audience to assist you. Tell your audience what you need and see who raises their hand. Look over the people with their hands raised to determine who will be a good volunteer and choose one. But do it quickly, because if you take too long, you will lose your audience's attention. Once you choose your volunteer, quickly and quietly bring them up to the stage. Be sure to ask your volunteer their name, though honestly, their name does not matter. This act is really just about you, the performer. Put your volunteer at ease, maybe with a small joke, so they do not realize the terrible risk they have taken coming up on stage with you. Next, you will need to show your volunteer the tools you will use during the act. Reach into the box and pull out the item labeled B1, a 6-inch long steel spike, sharp on one end, dull on the other, much like your conversation with the volunteer. Hand the spike to your volunteer. Allow them to verify for themselves and the members of the audience that it is a real 6-inch long steel spike. It does not bend. Have the volunteer try to bend it. It does not twist. Allow the volunteer to try and twist it. It does not collapse in any way. It is indeed a very real 6-inch long steel spike. Once the volunteer has verified the spike's authenticity, reach into the box and pull out the item labeled B2, a hammer. Hand the hammer to your volunteer. Allow them to verify for themselves and the members of the audience that it is indeed a real hammer, that there are no mirrors, no trap doors, there are no tricks of any kind. Also, it is not made out of rubber, plastic, or any similar material. Allow the volunteer to knock the hammer on the floor several times to reassure themselves and everyone else that it is indeed a very real hammer. But be careful, it is a rental. After the volunteer has verified to the audience that the tools are real, you can reveal to the audience why you brought up a volunteer to check your props. It is, of course, because there is no magic and there is no illusion during the act you learn to perform on how to do sideshow for fun and profit. Magic and illusion takes talent. Obviously, you do not have any, or you would not be listening to this album right now. Grasp the spike firmly in your hand, and placing the pointy end against the center of your skull, prepare with the hammer to pound the spike directly into the center of your skull. Here we go. 1, 2, stop a moment. Pay attention to what you are doing. Did you place the pointy end of the spike against your forehead? Then you have done it incorrectly. The forehead is not the center of the skull. Take a moment for this quick review of basic human physiology. There is the top of the skull. There is the bottom of the skull. And then there is the center of the skull, directly where the nose is. This time, grasp the spike by the head firmly with the thumb and forefinger and hold it against the side of your head with the head of the spike by your nose in full view of the audience. This will show the audience that the pointy end does indeed go back into the center of the brain pan. So if there is one mistake, one wrong move by you doing this act, you will damage yourself irreparably. Unless, of course, there is nothing really there, which is something your audience is probably starting to suspect. Now, grasping the nail firmly once more, place the pointy end at one nostril. Then, on the count of three, you will use the hammer to pound the spike directly into the center of the skull. 1, 2, 3. Do not just tap it or be sissy about it. I mean, really, pound the spike into your skull as hard as you can. Be sure the hammer makes a lot of noise so your audience knows that this is really happening. Once you have it most of the way into your nose, you will feel it begin to give a little as it hits the soft part of your brain. When you feel this, stop using the hammer and just use your finger to push it in a little further until the head of the spike rests firmly against the nostril. Now you may turn and bow slightly to the audience and allow them to be amazed that you are unhurt. Now, it is time to remove the spike from your skull. You are going to need the assistance of your audience volunteer for the final part of this act. Hand your volunteer the hammer again, and then assist them in holding it properly to pry the spike out of your skull, as you would pry a nail out of a block of wood. With your volunteer holding the hammer, hook the claw end around the head of the spike, then gently but firmly pull the nail slowly from the center of your skull. Once the spike has been completely removed, inspect it carefully, allowing your volunteer and the audience to do the same. Wait, is that some blood? Oh no, it's not.
Ladies and gentlemen, Greta the Green Monster and the Human Blockhead. And his lovely volunteer, is that Kate? Kate, get off the stage, man. You think it's fake. Get out of here. Go put that back. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a little, you got a little taste, but are you guys ready now for some more danger? No, I said, are you ready for more danger? Hit the music. Let's get some more danger going. Ladies and gentlemen, right now, your Freak Show Deluxe, who specialize in classic carnival sideshow acts, about to do something amazing and astounding. We're going to start out with this simple fox trap. Oh, it's not even a fox trap. It's like a muskrat trap. It's tiny. Lava Kenya, Anita, Charlotte, the little spider. Take that. All right, our next trap, ladies and gentlemen, I brought up here right here. The fox trap. A very simple trap right here. No, this isn't a fox trap either. This is a raccoon trap. Raccoon trap right here. This high tension, high quality spring keeps these jaws shut. Nearly 50 pounds of pressure per square inch. More than enough to break bones, to rend flesh. You, Greta the Green Monster, grab that. There we go. Step over closer to your sister, please. Now, ladies and gentlemen, does that seem like enough, or do you want more danger?
More danger!
Well, step right up here, Vivian. Since Vivian is the foxiest one up here on the stage next to me, I brought up here this fox trap right here. This high-pitched, high-quality spring keeps these jaws shut. Nearly 100 pounds of pressure per square inch. Very dangerous, very deadly. And last, and certainly not least, ladies and gentlemen, the dual spring beaver trap. Now these two high quality, high tension springs, did I say that already? Keep these jaws shut, nearly 150 pounds of pressure per square inch. Very dangerous, very risky. I'm looking for an adult. You, sir, you're coming with me. I need your help on the stage. Yes, you, come on. Ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause for my lovely assistant right here. Give it up for him. All right, now, sir, here's what I want you to do. You're gonna walk down each trap. I want you to check. I want you to try and pull the jaws open on the trap. Start down there with Charlotte, La Pequeña and Anita. That spring is holding those jaws shut about 25 pounds of pressure per square inch. Charlotte, once he's checked that it's not coming open, go ahead and set the trap, please. Grennan's is not coming open either. There we go. Grennan is gonna set his. Last but not least, go ahead and give that a try. Probably haven't had your hands on something that tight since high school, have you? No, he has not. All right, now. Oh, no, don't go anywhere yet. Because you're gonna help. You're gonna help Vivian Oblivion. She's gonna step on that one. You're gonna step on that one right there. I'm not doing it. I'm not crazy. All right, go ahead, put your foot on there. Compress the springs, open the jaws, set the traps. There we go. Is anyone getting their traps set? There we go. Vivian, you got it? All right, go. Yeah, that should be set. Carefully, gently take your feet out there. Go ahead, sir, take your foot off. One more over here. Step right down on there if you would. No, put your foot up right next to the jaw part of it. There you go. Is that good? Yeah, right there. Push down. Now notice this one especially. It takes both of us, our full weight, to compress the springs, open the jaw, set the trap. I'll let you take your foot off first. There, go right ahead. There we go. Okay, that's good. Okay, step over here. I do not step near the trap. Step right over here. Stand on that yellow line right there. There you go. All right, here we go. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here's what's going to happen. He's going to help all of you. You're all going to count to three. On the count of three, all four of us. La Pequeña Anita, the bravest little girl on four continents. Greta the Green Monster, the 13-year-old water kid. Vivian Oblivion. Our performer from the Great White North and myself, your pink-proof man, your right reverend Tommy Gunn, are going to slam our hands down into the trap. Those jaws are going to snap shut. It should break the bones in all of our hands. But body and mind work together in conjunction and concentration. We should all be able to overcome not just the pain, but the injury as well. Are you ready to get over to count to three? Oh yeah, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to count to three? Yeah! Some of you don't seem too sure. You might be from Kansas. That's that many. Are you ready? Yeah! Go ahead and lead them. And one,
two, three.
All right, not feeling any pain. All right. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you can see that the four of us here are not feeling much pain. Some have just been married for it. That's the reason why. All right, but let's see if we manage to remain uninjured. Sir, would you be so kind to try to pull open on the jaws, if you would? No, on the jaws right there. Show everybody it's still tight. It's not moving yet. Twist it around a little bit. That helps. That's right, it's not moving because it's a trap, you know, like marriage. All right, sir, stand on this spring. I'll stand on this one. We're going to open this one. Then we're going to help Vivian get out of hers. All right, Grennan, help Vivian with hers. Come on, there it is. Ladies and gentlemen, we're all unhurt at all. What do you say? Thank you for your help, sir. You're a wonderful volunteer, man. make your way safely down there. All right. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I think everybody's warmed up. Am I correct? All right. Well, then, ladies and gentlemen, our next performer, you've seen him on America's Got Talent. He's the youngest one ever to do this act. And even though it's been about 5 years, or it's been like 6 years since he was on that show, he's still the world's youngest professional knife thrower. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause, please, for Corinna the Green Monster. All right, now Corinna the Green Monster needs to warm up, first and foremost. All right, here we go. Feel good? All right. So we know here that Corinna can hit the broadside of a barn as it were, but let's see how he can do, whether he can hit a specific target. Ladies and gentlemen, what do you say? Man, he doesn't need your bidding. All right, hold on. I think, but perhaps the problem is it's too big of a target. I think we should go a little smaller. What do you say, ladies and gentlemen? Does that sound good? All right, Greta the Green Monster, win. You're ready. Enough? You want more to inch? Abby shaking her head no. What do you say, Vivian? What do they want?
More danger!
Now's the point of the show, ladies and gentlemen, that we look for a volunteer. The bravest person in the crowd today. What are you, crazy? Put your hands up. Have you not been watching this show? No. There's only one person brave enough to walk onto this stage, ladies and gentlemen. Take their place standing against the board while Brennan hurls sharp steel items around them. And who is that? Ladies and gentlemen, no one else but the bravest little girl on five continents. How about a round of applause for Lumber King Anita Charlotte, the little spider. All right, Charlie, you're gonna hurt a whole bunch of parents like, oh, no. You are not wrong, folks. Here we go, Brandon, when you're ready. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, Brandon the Green Monster and Charlotte. Spider. You know, Greta, we have a few more minutes to go. We have a few more minutes. Let's do something really dangerous. Grab those knives. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Let's see how he goes throwing around the fat guy. Hold on. Now, I know a lot of you parents out there are saying to yourselves, how? Why did you trust him with that? And how did you get the little sister to stand against the board while he threw knives around her? My kids won't get along the backside of the car for even 5 minutes at a time. But ladies and gentlemen, I'll tell you how you do it. You promise the little sister she gets to do her own act during the show. Would you like to see Charlotte's act, ladies and gentlemen?
Yeah!
I was hoping you would say yes, because I'm turning it over to her right now. Ladies and gentlemen, please, a big round of applause for Leopard King Anita, Charlotte the Little Spider!
Asking me.
Nicely done. Thank you very much. Now, ladies and gentlemen, because, of course, we've got to keep this show moving, I want to bring out our next performer to the stage. Please, a big round of applause for the unbelievable Vivian Oblivion! Put the mic in that, Chris. That isn't working at all. There you go. All right.
Gentlemen, hold on to your hats, and ladies, hold on to your gentlemen, as I present to you quite possibly one of the most unusual things you'll ever see a person do. My name is Vivian Oblivion. Tonight, I'm going to perform the very ancient, but also very questionable art of sword swallowing. It is one of the most dangerous acts in the sideshow. It is so dangerous, in fact, that I dare not do it alone without a volunteer. So I'm going to need... so tall, dark, handsome. All right, go, Brennan, go. Get me a good one. What's better than Tinder? Come on, give me a good one. All right, awesome. Round of applause for a brave volunteer. Hi, what's your name? Nikki? Nice to meet you, Nikki. Okay, so what's going to happen is you're going to be everyone's eyes and ears inspecting the blade for any button switches, midgets, ears, or trap doors. That the blade does not fold or retract into the handle. Legit? Legit blade, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so I'm going to take the sword. It's gonna go past my lips, down my esophagus, into the pit of my stomach, and then I'm going to fold my body in half, and it'll be your job to pull the sword out of my body. I like the confidence. All right, so you ready? Let's do this. Down the hatch. Without a scratch.
Living at home, far from the city, at the midnight door.
stop. Boo. The world's youngest professional life thrower, Corinna the Green Monster. The most dangerous little girl on four continents, La Pequeña Arenita, the little spider. And let's not forget Vivian Oblivion. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm your Reverend Tommy Gunn. We are Hollywood's own Freak Show Deluxe. But don't go away yet, folks, because our show is not done. Before we are done here, I want to make sure every single one of you has an opportunity to come to our stage and volunteer to become a part of our show. So here is what we are going to do. I'm going to move up a little act, a classic act of the Carnival Sideshow that we like to call the Coffin of Doom. Doom. The Coffin of Doom, ladies and gentlemen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here's what's going to happen. We're going to take one of our performers. It's going to be Vivian Oblivion. We're going to stick her here inside the Coffin of Doom. And as you can see, it's a very small box. It's less than 6 feet long. It's only 18 inches deep. It's only 18 inches tall. And then we're going to make things very dangerous for her. All right, ladies and gentlemen? And once we do that, my friends, I'm going to offer an opportunity for every single one of you to come up on this stage and become a part of our show. You ready to see that heaven? All right, let's hit some music, miss, and let's see what happens. And there she is, the lovely Vivian Oblivion. Yes, in case you're wondering, she did need to remove part of her costume in order to do this particular and peculiar act. So we get her up, we're gonna put her down inside the casket, the coffin. Oh, doom. There we go. I'll take this towel. Thank you very much. All right. Charlotte, will you grab the other side there? We need to close the lid. Take this over there. Please place it out of the way. Thank you so much. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here's what happens next. I'm going to take each one of these hard, sharp, and hard wood blades. There we go. And I'm going to start cutting Vivian Oblivion into a lot of little pieces. All right, here we go. There's one Grenny Green Monster. Help me out, there we go. Now Brennan's got several short blades right there, or not, I shouldn't say short, I should say thinner blades. So does La Pequeña Arenita, thank you very much. We're gonna stick these right in through here. There we go. Now, does that seem like enough, or does this audience want more danger?
More danger!
I'm glad you said more danger, because we brought these sharp saws right here. I'm gonna stick this one right down through here. Brennan's gonna stick another one down through. Well, it's caught. Here, I got it. Can we get it, please? There we go. Woo! It's a little more of a show than I was expecting. Excellent! All right. So we get this. You put that one through there. Ladies and gentlemen, is that enough for you? One more danger! Oh, I'm so glad you said more danger, because we brought these four razor-sharp machetes. We're going to stick them right down through her like that. Oh! There we go. Now, ladies and gentlemen, do you see any blood pouring outside? The casket of doom. Do you see any blood pouring out of there? That is because Vivian Oblivion, you may not realize this is also contortionist. She's managed to twist and contort her body around all 13 sharp and dangerous objects. Let me see your hands in the air. Who wants to come up right now and see it? Who wants to come up and see her? Go on, let me see your hands high in the air. Even if you don't want to, put your hands in the air. Make me feel good. There we go. Now take that hand high in the air. Reach deep down into your pocket or purse, or the pocket or purse, or the person next to you. Grab a single dollar bill, just like this one right here. Right over here, grab it, take it out there. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take that dollar bill, you're gonna walk, don't run, walk right over to here. La Pequeña standing right there with a bucket. You're gonna put your dollar bill in the bucket. You get to come up on stage, walk right here across the front of the stage and see for yourself how Vivian Oblivion manages to do it and survive. And then Grenny Green Monster will make you down. So come one, come all, come big, come small, short and tall, we love them all. Don't be shy, don't walk on by. If you miss this chance, you're gonna cry. Yes, you can take a photo with her. Yes, you can shoot a selfie with her. Yes, you can talk to her and make sure she is alive on the inside. Vivian Oblivion inside the Coffin of Doom. Come right out, you're gonna walk right across the front right here. Take a look right down there. Good, you've got your camera. Have your friend hold camera. Go ahead, she's right in there. Don't be shy. Don't walk on by. Now, my friends, I know some of you gentlemen, I saw you checking out Vivian while she was doing some sword swallowing. I don't blame you. You're trying to figure out how to get a girl like that to give you a call. Here's how you do it, my friends. Get in your wallet, bring out a 10, a 20, something like that, a bigger bill. Write your telephone number on it. Drop it directly into the box. The bigger the bill, the more the chance she's gonna notice it and give you a call. So that's the way. Now, ladies, if you're tired of your boyfriend, or you're tired of your husband, tired of your husband's boyfriend, always telling you he doesn't want to hear how you bend over backwards for him, bring it up to the stage. I'll let him see what it looks like when a real woman has to bend over backwards for a man. That's right. Your only chance to see it here. Now, I hope you took photos. I hope you shot video, as we want you to post every bit of it online. That's right. Go to social media and link everything to Freak Show Deluxe. That's right. You'll find Freak Show Deluxe on all the social media. We're on Facebook. We're on Instagram. We're on Twitter, Tinder, Farmers Only. Always swipe right. You can find your Freak Show Deluxe all those places. Now, once we've got through the entire line, don't be shy. We're still doing this till the music ends. Come on up here. We've got some great Freak Show Deluxe merchandise. We have some amazing shirts like the kind this gentleman has right here, but it's some fancy new colors. We've got hats. We've got beanies. We've got hot sauce. We've got coffee. Everything right up here. So come on up, my friends. Let's see. This is your last chance to make your way up here. And of course, the members of Freak Show Deluxe will be standing down here to get photos and autographs with you. All right, come on up here, ladies and gentlemen. That's the end. Let's let Vivian Oblivion out of the box, if we could, please. Thank you so much. Carefully and gently, if you'd be so kind. Now, Cake and Taylor are over there on the merchandise, taking care of all your merchandise needs right there. Carefully, please. Thank you. Still very sharp. Very sharp. I'm going to put this inside here. Oh, there's that one right there. Thank you very much. Chair for her, please, so she can get down. If you'd be so kind. Woo, got it? There she goes. All right. There you are. Oh, you've been there for quite a while. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, if you had a good time with us tonight, I hope you'll tell a friend. If you didn't, I hope you get throat cancer, dive there, never uttering another world. We're at our Freak Show Deluxe, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Enjoy for a right fest.